Okay, so you folks at home know we here at KTLA, we just love our viewers.
Love, love, love.
Love, love, love. So we're spending even more time with our KTLA family, with our Friends with Friends watch parties.
It turns out the KTLA team loves Friends so much. Just watching it, you know, it's just not enough. We had to chat about it in a new podcast, and joining us live is one of the hosts and, of course, our boss, our big boss, the KTLA News Director, Jason Ball. Good morning, Jason. Thank you for spending our Saturday morning with us. How are you?
Good morning, friends.
All right, let's talk about this podcast. How did this all start?
Well, KTLA is known for a couple of things. Obviously, the news. But then we've been running Friends for years and years and years, and we have the entire library. So the watch party came about, and then the natural progression was, let's take a deep dive into all of the episodes. And there are 236 episodes of Friends for over 10 years. So we're going one by one and studying the kind of evolution of the story arc, the character arc, the guests that have come on. It's been really an interesting project to look at a TV show from a kind of a critical eye throughout the entire series.
What types of things are you looking at?
Well, just the story arc. You know, you can tell from the very beginning episode that they planned for this chemistry between Rachel and Ross, and you see how it develops, now it takes a step back, and how they kind of toy with the audience all the way through. But then you also learn a lot more about Phoebe, who was supposed to be kind of a minor character. She becomes this really interesting character, and she's actually my favorite character. So it's really interesting to see the character act. And then you see all these actors who kind of started as guest stars on that and then went off to do other things. There are, you know, lots of other things. And then you see the strategy that NBC was doing to do the crossovers, to have George Clooney appear on the show to kind of give it some work during the height of ER. So it's really interesting to just see all the different elements for it and the cleverness of the writing. Some of it's like, they take vaudeville elements, they take classic sitcom elements. So it's really interesting to look at it from a little more of a critical eye instead of just a passive eye that we usually, and you know, Friends fans are fanatics, so it's fun to hang out with them too and
right.
Enjoy them.
And speaking of fanatics, so Jackie is one of your co-hosts as well. She's a fanatic about Friends. She knows everything about Friends. So I've listened. It's part of my research because, you know, we do the watch party. So I have listened to the podcast, and it's so funny because it's interesting to see how different generations see it. You know, like listening to you talk about, I think you guys were like, well, what was your first car? And then like you said what your first car was, and then you said, oh yeah, I used to wear those clothes. See the clothes that, you know, Chandler's wearing? I used to wear that when I was in high school. Like, it was kind of neat to see the different generations and how you guys see the show, don't you think?
I think that's the interesting thing about the show is that, you know, I am of that age. I'm the same age as the Friends, and I watched it when it came out in the 90s. But then for, you know, I'm doing the show with Jackie Rodriguez and Vanessa Martinez, two millennial Latinas who, you know, were kids when the show came out. So for them to have such an affinity for it and to find such, you know, sheer joy in watching it is really, really interesting.
So we're looking at some video right now of one of the adorable young Friends fans. And did that little guy get to interview one of the stars of the show as well?
Okay, so this is a great story. So this kid's name is Naftali Arden. He lives in London. He had his bar mitzvah. He was supposed to have a full-on Friends-themed bar mitzvah. He was going to have tables named after the characters. They had the red sofa for a photo booth. And then quarantine happened, so he had a virtual Friends bar mitzvah on Facebook Live, and 4,000 random people showed up because they just saw the title Friends Bar Mitzvah. And then he was on the James Corden show, who's apparently also a big Friends fan. And James had Courtney Cox join them, so he got to talk to Courtney Cox.
Oh my gosh, that's so fun.
And then she sent him a football table like the one in Joey and Chandler's apartment. So this kid is like living the dream.
Wow.
And he's so, so funny. He's watched, we interviewed him on an episode that came out earlier. And he has watched all, he's 13, he's watched all the entire series 7 times.
Wow, 7 times, oh my gosh. Okay, we have to ask you about this. So I know you've heard about this. Friends co-creator Marta Kaufman recently talked about the lack of diversity on the show, and she said, quote, "I wish I knew then what I know today. I would have made very different decisions. We've always encouraged people of diversity in our company, but I didn't do enough. I didn't do enough." What are your thoughts about that?
I mean, I think it's great that she said that. I mean, this controversy is not new. I remember when the show came out in 1994, and a friend in the newsroom, coincidentally, said, "You mean to tell me that they live in New York City and they don't have any black friends?" And I would add to that, they don't have any Latino friends, they don't have any gay friends, you know. So yes, this has been a thing that happens. And to Marta's point, people who hire, when we hire people in those positions, we need to make a conscious effort not to just reflect ourselves, mm-hmm. but also the larger community. And so it's important to reflect the community that we serve, because even an entertainment show, it is still, we're on the public airwaves and we're doing a public service, and it's important to reflect this. So we have to, as you know, to paraphrase Maya Angelou, when you know better, do better.
Right.
So we all have to keep that in mind, and it takes a little effort sometimes. But again, I find such joy that these two millennial Latinos that I do the show with are so into it and have such a thing for it. So it doesn't diminish the show, but yes, it would have been cool had, you know, they had incorporated some other voices in the show too.
So can you talk about tonight's show? You guys have an episode about lasagna, and what can we expect for the Friends with Friends watch party?
Okay, so one of the things we figured out, all the episodes are named the one with, or the one that, or the one, they start the one with so-and-so. This one is called, the ones for today's podcast, but it's called the one with a dozen lasagnas. And there's this little bit about Monica makes 12 lasagnas and she's trying to get rid of them. But it's also the 12th episode of the series. So they do all these kind of clever and interesting things in there. So we take a look at the creators and how they approach the show and that sort of thing. But also our other friend, Dayna Devon, is our guest star because she was extra in the 90s covering all of them. And she tells a great story about, I'm not saying she broke the law, but how she may have snuck into one of the friends' houses.
Yes, she shared that with us a little bit too. Okay, before we let you go, tonight is our Friends with Friends watch party. We want to remind you about that. So please join us 8 o'clock tonight, 8 to 10, and there will be live streaming as well on YouTube. So please, it's a lot of fun. Hashtag KTLA watch party. Before we leave, wait, we have to go back to Jason. Are you like in the Hall of Constitution? We know you're a beekeeper, but what's going on with all those flags?
Now my nerdiness is really going to show. I'm a flag collector, too. So I try to get flags from wherever we've traveled.
Okay, show us. Yeah. You have some really cool ones.
This is the Puerto Rican flag, and tomorrow's the Puerto Rican Day Parade in New York. So that's got to happen. Well, this is Sweden, Turkey, Cuba, France. And this is an interesting flag. This was the flag that flew over my dad's junior high, and they were taking it down when they changed it from 48 stars to 50 stars.
Huh. Wow, we could do a whole segment on your flags.
So when they added Hawaii and Alaska to the flag, this is an old one. It has 48 stars, so it's kind of a historical. And I found it, like, stuffed away in a trunk somewhere one day. I'm like, what's this?
Huh. How do you wrap your news director? We got to go.
We got to go.
Thank you. All right, make sure to check out the Friends with Friends podcast. It is hosted by Jason Ball and producers Jackie and Vanessa. You can find it at ktla.com/podcast. We'll be right back.